and social justice, a San Francisco icon, the Reverend Cecil Williams. And that is how we begin today's community celebration of love, of acceptance, of tolerance, of inclusion, of diversity, San Francisco Bay Area. Good afternoon, my fellow citizens, my brothers and my sisters. I wish you could see my view of you all right now. Didn't we need this day?
A month of introspection and preparation for a new year. The shofar, the ram's horn, is sounded each day during this month. It instructs us to wake up and live in the world with intention. Today we have gathered together in solidarity. We are a kaleidoscope of different faith traditions, ethnicities, skin colors, sexual orientations, political parties, and communities. But we are one people. Sharing the fundamental and unshakable belief that the society we want guarantees respect, honor, and dignity to each of its members. We are here to say unequivocally that we will never stop working to ensure those basic rights for everyone. In honor of this vision, we sound the shofar. Tequila!
Into violence. San Francisco is a city of love and compassion. And we will always lead with love and compassion. And that's why it's important that we're all here together the day before hate shows up on our shores. Because if you lead a city of love, you will have a city that has free city college. If you have a city of love and compassion, you will have people that are building and preserving the most affordable housing in the city's history. When you have a city that leads with love and compassion, you will have public housing residents that are citizens of San Francisco and not residents of public housing. When you have a city that leads with love and compassion, you're going to have jobs for all of the kids and an education system that will support them. And I want to say this because we should say it for the rest of the country. When you have a city that leads with love and compassion, then we are and will always be a city of sanctuary. This is what a city that leads with love and compassion is all about. We will resist the wall. We will resist the registry. We will support our Muslim brothers and sisters because they're really under attack. And we will always be the city of love and compassion. Thank you for sharing that. All of you for being here.
Full of people on Chrissy Field who are going to espouse hate. But there's going to be an army of lovers in this city, throughout the city, making it very clear we are united against hate. You know, 13 years ago, on these very steps, we made history in the world because we wanted to make sure that if people loved each other, they had the right to get married. And we are oftentimes at the forefront of every new social movement. And we are at the forefront of another social movement that says, not in our America, we are not going to allow hate to infect us and to become a cancer in this country. Love will win. Thank you all.
Rose from public housing here in this city to become the second highest ranking official in this great city. Give it up for our treasure, the wonderful supervisor, president of the Board of Supervisors, London Breed.
Two young black women's lives. One was wearing a hijab. My brother, along with the two other men, stood up to stop him and were then viciously stabbed by the attacker. Micah Fletcher survived a violent assault. My brother, Talishan, along with Rick Best, a father and an Army veteran, did not survive the wounds. I'll never see my brother again in this life. I will miss him every day, but there are no words for how proud I am. He stood up for what was right that day. He stood up for love. Talishan chose love every day of his life. He practiced love, so when the time came to live it, he didn't hesitate. He was ready. He chose love when it mattered the most. He took his final breath in the arms of a Native American woman who came to his aid and was riding with him on the train. She comforted him, and I spoke to her, and she told me his last words. In his last moments, he said, "Please tell everyone on this train I love them." This may be the hardest lesson on earth to learn. In this challenging political climate, it can be so difficult simply to love each other. It is so disheartening to see hate, bigotry, and indecency become normalized in our country, our home. When I heard the same white supremacist group who radicalized my brother's murder was coming to my community too, I knew I needed to stand up with love. I've called San Francisco my home for the better part of 20 years. I've built a company here, I've built a community, I've built a family here. And I'm proud to raise my daughter in a city defined by diversity, beauty, celebration of life, innovation, art, and most importantly, love. Choosing love is not an easy path. My brother Talishan stood up for his community, and he paid the ultimate price. On May 26th, I lost a brother, but I gained a hero, I gained a teacher. He chose love. Our family chooses love. For the future of our children, of our country, of humanity, may we all choose love. Thank you.
We are here because we know when the whole world is shaking at its very foundations, when moral codes are put to the test, when the premises of respecting one another are challenged and questioned, the best thing we can do is stand together.
Because in a moment where the very basic idea of loving your neighbor is put to the test, this is when we show up.
This is when we demonstrate our love for each other. And this is the city that practically invented love, isn't it? This is when we demonstrate commitment. So this love is our message to the world, but I want it to be a message among us here. Gender, whatever religion, whomever you love or marry, whatever our physical or mental ability, whatever race, whatever our past, however long we have lived here or what language we speak, we are in this together. We are neighbors.
Yeah.
Or any of those old, stubborn, destructive, violent lies. Our presence means we have the opportunity to each day walk with dignity and responsibility, that we as Jews have the opportunity to do our part here as stakeholders in America, and like everybody else here today, every single person here today, we deserve to love and be loved, to respect and be respected to walk in San Francisco holding our heads high. Now this may be a hard week, but we here, we have seen hard weeks before. This week will just make us more focused. And we will remember that this city and those of us who live here are stronger than any hatred that decides to pay a visit.
Yeah.
Than any hatred that decides to, like, take a weekend here. We will take this visit. We will take their visit. And we will take their hatred as an invitation to love each other even more.
If you could see what we all see, I want everyone to take a moment and look to a neighbor to your left or your right, someone who you don't know, who may not look like you, and say to them, I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
Say to them, I stand with you.
I do love you.
We are worried about the weather today. We thought today was going to be cloudy. But the sun is shining on San Francisco today because the forces of good are with us.
Yeah.
A few days ago, we all experienced a historic eclipse. Early on in the history of human civilization, we feared eclipses because it was viewed at that time that a life-affirming sun was being taken over by darkness, the darkness of evil. And we know today that eclipses end, but we need to remember that they end, because the darkness that comes from intolerance and hate, right behind that darkness is light and love. And our goal today and tomorrow is to be that light, to be that love. White supremacists may say one thing, but let me say something here. Love today, love tomorrow, love forever. Can you repeat that after me? Love today, love tomorrow, love forever. Godspeed. Thank you very much.
On civil rights and civil liberties, the director of the Haas Institute for a Fair and Inclusive Society, please welcome Dr. John Powell.
Good afternoon, San Francisco and the Bay Area. So these are troubling times. Our society is going through a profound shift. The current landscape challenges many of our fundamental values, our assumptions, and our democracy. We have to go back to a previous time to find the country so divided. All the way back to this time. Yet we have clear internal choices. The core institutions, the core values of the people of this country need all of us. We saw a young woman standing up for love,
the front lines
being
to stand
mowed
against
down by hate. We saw police officers who were trying to keep the community safe, give their life in that process. We know that hate can be violent and can be virulent. But we also know that love can and will prevail if we stand up. To try to divide the Bay Area.
The reason for it?
Yeah.
You know that they're trying to divide the country.
Since?
And they're trying to do this.
white, some white people
trying to undermine our business.
In their families,
they have may have black. Sympathy.
Later, we figured
they
out that's not true.
We're black,
and so there's a long history,
we have history
of hatred and fear,
and more importantly,
of
we
some
have
white people,
on the
many
side
black people,
and each other.
And we thought we made progress on that. We did not, but there's
we
a
will
long
not be divided. We will stand
out. Whites who still think they're better than blacks and Jews.
It is necessary to actively resist. Hate,
so, but America
racism,
doesn't stand for that.
Misogyny,
everyone in the world knows
homophobia,
stands
xenophobia,
for
and other forms
and
that would exclude any person.
Other countries recently,
that resistance is not enough.
That most Americans.
That's why we're here today, not just in opposition to hate, but in celebration of love and celebration of each other. But that's not enough either. We have to use our time, our money, our power, our organizing to make this dream a reality. We need each other. The Bay Area needs us. The country needs us. The planet needs us. We share it with other people and other life throughout the world. So, what do we do during this time? What is our challenge? I want to leave you with a few things that we might do. We have different strategies. And in those strategies, some of us may march, some of us may boycott, some of us may organize our workplace, some of us may run for office, some of us may hold each other. But we all have to be engaged. We all have to do more than we have done in the past. We have a compact, and I want to suggest that you go to newcompact.org, and if you are so moved, sign that compact. But more importantly, I want you to commit that the future will be our future, all of our future. This country does not belong to one race. This country does not belong to one people. This country belongs to all of us. This land belongs to all of us. So as I end, I would say, be out there. Make your voices heard. Make your value real. But also be safe. Help those around you be safe. And demand the accountability of our leaders, which we have. Demand the accountability of our police, which we have, to help keep the people safe as they protest hate, as they protest against hate, as they protest against exclusion. And in doing so, remember our core values is inclusion. Our core values is love. Our core values is about holding on to each other, holding on to this planet, and making America and the world a place safe for life. Thank you.
We want to acknowledge all of our special guests and dignitaries that are with us today. Also here, City College Trustee Alex Randolph.
Thank you. I can't believe that we are actually here in 2017 to unite against hate. I was born in 1962, and I can tell you firsthand that hate is dangerous. It's not to be taken lightly. So when the call went out to unite against hate, I was in Texas, but I responded right away that I would catch the red eye and make sure that I get home, because hatred has no place here in San Francisco. Hatred has no place here in the entire Bay Area. Right about the time I was born, hate killed John F. Kennedy. And less than a year later, or two, hate killed Medgar Evers. Hate killed Martin Luther King. This is all in the same years in the 60s, right after one another. Hate killed Malcolm X. Hate killed Robert F. Kennedy. Robert Kennedy. Hate is dangerous. And we can't sit back and say, well, let them demonstrate, it'll go away. That's not the way hate operates. So we have to stay on top of it and let it know that it can't be comfortable here in our home. We can't tolerate hate. As a matter of fact, what we want to do is introduce them to more love. The Bay is about love. Anybody love the Bay here? Anybody love the Bay? Well, let's celebrate love. Love is love. Let's show them how we celebrate love. Love is love. Love is love. Bring it up. We can't hear it. We can't hear it. Where's that music? We was gonna celebrate it with you. Start that over and turn it up so the people can feel good. Start it over and turn it up. Bring that music up. Yeah. Turn it up. Turn that music up. Yeah, let them hear it.
It's all about the love. Love is love, 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 love. We love you, Frisco.
this is so, I am, this is so fun! This is great! This is great! All right, next up to the podium, a former San Francisco supervisor, now representing California's 11th district, please welcome State Senator Scott Wiener!
Let's hear it for San Francisco values! You know, like some of the other speakers are, and then we know what happened, and we cannot be silent. Some people want us to ignore what's happening in Chrissy Field. We can't ignore it. It's there. This president has let that out of the box, and we need to put it back into the box. No more KKK. No more Nazis. No more white supremacists. We need to send a crystal clear message to these people that if they're going to come for our immigrant neighbors, if they're going to come for our transgender children and service members, if they're going to come for women's...
The tactics are cowardice! The tactics are ineffective against Amor. And that is why they did not go to Chrissy Field. They did not have enough gumption to do what they set out to do. And here, they could meet us here and speak with us here. But they are not even here as well. They will hide, and they say that they're going to pop up, but we are not playing jack-in-the-box games with them. We are here to stand our ground and show dignity. We are the people of color, the grassroots of San Francisco, of the world. So right now, this is a victory. And so we are going to have this as a victory rally. A rally so that we get to know each other right now. I recommend and suggest everybody here right now turn to your neighbor right now and say, "What's up, home?" Give them a big embrace. Love them. Show them how San Francisco does it. Because that's how we will stay strong here in San Francisco. Now, the plans for the day are this. We're going to have some more danzante. We're going to have some music. We may have some speeches as well. And then we plan to have enough people here so that we wrap around in unity against any white racist that try to ever come to San Francisco so they will know our spirit and it will never be defeated.
Woo!
Thank you.
Thank you. right here who are watching, all of us are out here standing as the fascists, and we do these die-ins to represent what the world looks like from the vantage point of people who are black and brown, who are immigrants, who are queer and trans, people who live in the war zones like Syria or Afghanistan that Trump has escalated. We're doing this because we don't want to live in this world. We realize that we have to put our bodies out to stand against it, to fight back against the Trump censorship.
Three, two, one.
The blood
Thank you. was annoyed by this.
Movement. Think about Tahrir Square in Egypt. Think about South Korea just a few months ago, where people rose up, millions of people, day after day, night after night, not stopping until this fascist, until their corrupt regime in South Korea was driven out of office, and that is exactly what happened. Don't say it cannot happen here. Don't say we have to wait until 2020. If you say we have to wait until the next election to get rid of this fascist regime in the White House, then you are condemning whole groups of people to death and destruction. Don't think I'm exaggerating, okay? Don't think I'm exaggerating. Six whole countries of people are already banned because of their religion. The Supreme Court instituted Trump's Muslim ban, most of it. Transgender people right now are being purged out of the military and banned from the military. The environment, which was already being destroyed, is now being destroyed at an accelerating pace. So we cannot wait for some savior up above, some investigation, some impeachment. We can't wait for the next election. We have to drive this regime from power now. November 4th, it begins. No Trump, no KKK, no fascist USA. No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
No Trump,
no KKK, no fascist USA.
All of our
choose love, I choose to love you. Madame Girl.
Wait.
y'all. We need a little bit of swag here. All day! I'm talking about revolutionary swag. We're talking about the swag that we have right on our side. History is on our side. We are right and they are wrong. The white supremacists, the Nazis in the streets, they are wrong and we are right. We are right. And this right here, my family, we're going on November 4th. Sign up. Get this flyer right here. And sign up. And become part of the movement that's going to stop this. And you are part of that.
Okay, I think free speech, the demand for free speech is an answer
to the attacks on free speech, which people seemingly that you're aligned with are trying to thwart. And I don't know if you looked at the legislation that's being passed through. We're sitting here arguing, but by the way, shake my hand, please. Because we need to be coming together. We are not the enemy. The people that are trying to shut us all up, that's the enemy. Okay, we can dialogue, I can respect you, but we all should be here kind of greater understanding who's pulling your strings,
so where were
who's
you,
pulling my strings.
Where was all this peace and love stuff when there was, where was it then?
Okay.
It's the same groups that are attacking you, man. Revolution looks
we're
for
not attacking each other.
But Revolution looks for the one who has their own.
What's wrong with Berkeley? You seem to be talking about revolutionary books. I have a great, tremendous pride about revolutionary
okay,
books.
When people
this
were,
is a bookstore.
Here's why this matters. People were attacked with violent events. There was clear evidence of it in the police interference. There's been a record because the mass revolutionary bookstore owner said nobody cooperated with the police. So you have clear assaults. You have people in mass weren't stopped by the police.
Since when did the owner of revolutionary bookstore wield this power? You're crazy, man. You just
kind of told me that
you just made some claim that he said don't cooperate with police, so your partners were attacked? I'm not sure.
But when
what's
matter for
what's your point?
It's a matter of who's
they all are encouraging folks who are with them.
No papers, no fear. Here, give me a question.
They know kids are marching here.
No paper, no beer.
Dignity is marching here.
No paper, no beer.
Immigrants are marching here.
No paper, no beer.
Dignity is marching here.
Sin papeles y sin miedo.
Immigrants are marching here.
No paper, no beer.
Dignity is marching here.
Sin papeles y sin miedo.
Immigrants are marching here.
No paper, no beer.
Dignity is marching here.
Sin papeles y sin miedo.
Immigrants are marching here.
No paper, no beer.
Dignity is marching here.
Sin papeles y sin miedo.
Immigrants are marching here.
No papers, no fear.
Dignity is marching here.
Sin papeles y sin miedo.
Immigrants are marching here. Woo! Woo!
Defensive line, folks. We are defending the people who have gathered to send a clear message. No Nazis in our town. No white supremacy in our town. This is a defensive line, so we're doing defensive actions. We're not going to be intimidated by their violence.
Immigrants are marching here, no papers, no fear.
Immigrants are marching here, no papers, no fear.
Immigrants marching here, no papers, no fear.
The police are putting their gas masks on. If you don't want to be part of the defensive line, we're asking you to move over to the grass.
Who are you really defending here? These cops putting their gas masks on.
Oh, yeah.
with deportation. Liberation. Down, down. Deportation. Up with liberation. Down, down. Deportation. Up with liberation. Down, down with 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 deportation.
Where do we have to take us? Hello, sir.
Hello. Hello, sir.
That's what you get for being a fucking Nazi, you
fat
guy!
Are you serious? Anybody lose some glasses? Anybody lose some glasses?
So that's the flag. That's what happened. That's what happened.
You know, kids, when the tear gas starts, it's time for me to get the hell out of Dodge. Adios.